Hi, you are viewing Disciples of the Word YouTube channel. Welcome to a presentation of the talk delivered to the Apostleship of Prayer Group of the Presentation of the Child Jesus Parish of the Diocese of Paranaque, Philippines, on March 1, 2019. Let us all be still and start with a short prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again. Rejoice. Your kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. This talk presentation is about the Apostleship of Prayer module on prayer for the month of March 2019. The theme for the month of March is What Hinders Our Prayers. The intention of Pope Francis for March, requested of the Pope's Worldwide Prayer Network, is that Christian communities, especially those who are persecuted, feel that they are close to Christ and have their rights respected. There are two objectives of this intention for the persecuted Christian communities, which are: one, that they feel close to Christ in the midst of all their trials and tribulations. And two, that their rights be respected. Everybody must have the right to practice their religion, free of persecution. And yet, in many parts of the world, Christians are prevented from practicing their religion, to the point that many lay believers, clergy, and missionaries are martyred for their faith. In the movie Call Me Francis or Llamame Francisco, we see that Pope Francis himself was a first-hand witness to all of this during the dictatorship in Argentina. His intention does not come from nothing, but actual experiences that prompted him to take notice and must have urged him to request for this intention of his prayer network. This situation is true today and is a reality in different parts of the world. In his recent visit to the United Arab Emirates, where he celebrated the first Holy Mass outside. He also met with Muslim leaders in the UAE, where he said that there is a need to build bridges among religions, that there is a need for brotherhood among peoples for the purpose of world peace, that Muslims and Christians must talk to each other, and most importantly, that we must all build the future together, or there might be no future to look at. We must pray that despite the difficulties they are experiencing, that the persecuted Christians continue to stand firm in their faith, that they be courageous and strong, and continue to hold on to the teachings of Christ with much fervor and perseverance. Let us pray that they are reminded that even in the midst of persecution, they still remember the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, that they will be rewarded for their perseverance with the assurance of the kingdom of heaven. The scripture verse for the month of March comes from St. Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapter 6, verse 18. With all prayer and supplication, pray at every opportunity in the Spirit. To that end, be watchful with all perseverance and supplication for all the holy ones. Paul's letter to the Ephesians is most noted for its description of the relationship between Christ and His church. This letter is really an exhortation or a letter of encouragement. This letter is full of reminders that the kingdom of God is the reward for those who put their faith and trust in the Lord. We can find four alls in this scriptural verse. Number one, all times. Number two, all prayer. Number three, all perseverance. And number four, all saints or all holy ones. Furthermore, the repetition of the word all indicates the importance of this type of prayer. The first all times. Pray at every opportunity. In the verses before this one, Paul talked about the armor of God before going into a spiritual battle. Yet he did not place prayer among the armor of God. However, as we approach this verse, we see that Paul sees prayer as a necessity of the equipped spiritual soldier. After equipping oneself with the armor of God, it is constant prayer that will make one succeed against the spiritual opponents. Paul also uses this exhortation in his first letter to the church in Thessalonica when he said, "Pray without ceasing." Paul also said that our prayers must be guided by the Holy Spirit. Pray at every opportunity in the Spirit. This means praying as best we can, with the confidence that the Spirit Himself will intercede for us. The second all is all prayer. With all prayer and supplication. The word used in the Greek manuscript is prosyuke, which is a Greek general word for prayer. As such, this refers to all kinds of prayer which may be called for by the occasion, the situation, or even through the prodding of the Holy Spirit. Again, going to the Greek manuscript, we see the Greek word diesis, which refers to what we call supplication, or to prayers with a pleading quality made to meet certain particular needs. The third all is all perseverance. And stay alert in this with all perseverance. Again, in the Greek manuscript, which uses the word proskartenesis, it has to do with persistence and perseverance. It can also be translated into the simple word of being steadfast. Here, Paul calls us to be firm and unwavering in our prayers for all the holy ones. Finally, the fourth all is all saints or all holy ones. Paul says that our prayer of supplication must be for all saints, and therefore he refers to intercessory prayers. All saints do not refer to the word saints as we know of today, which are those who were canonized by the church. During the writing of this letter, there were no canonized saints yet. Therefore, we again go to the Greek manuscript where the word used was hagios, which refers to the holy ones. The holy ones referred to in the early church writings such as Acts, letter to the Romans, letter to the Corinthians, and letter to the Philippians, are the baptized believers of that time, who are said to be holy because all Christians are set apart for God's service. The Apostleship of Prayer March module requests the grace for two purposes: to nurture a fruitful prayer life, and to avoid and resolve obstacles that may prevent the efficacy of prayer. The request to nurture a fruitful prayer life may be likened to the request of the disciples of Jesus when they asked him, "Lord, teach us to pray." The answer can be found in the response of Jesus when he taught them the Lord's Prayer. In order to nurture a fruitful prayer life, there are three requirements. One, it must be offered in faith. The scriptural foundation can be found in the letter of James, chapter 1, verse 6 to 7. But he should ask in faith, not doubting, for the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea that is driven and tossed about by the wind. For that person must not suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. Just like the Lord's Prayer, we confidently and faithfully call on God, our Father, whom we know will listen to his children. Two, we must keep God's commandments as confirmed in the first letter of John, chapter 3, verses 21 to 22. We have confidence in God and receive from him whatever we ask, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. As in the Lord's Prayer, we give our praise and love to God as we say, "Hallowed be thy name." And we commit to do as he commands when we say, "Thy kingdom come," as we look forward to the coming of the kingdom by preparing ourselves. Three, our prayers must be according to God's will. as said in the first letter of John, chapter 5, verses 14 to 15. And we have this confidence in Him, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. And if we know that He hears us in regard to whatever we ask, we know that what we have asked for is ours. The Lord's Prayer acknowledges that everything must be according to the will of God. As we say, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And so, as we receive the grace to nurture a fruitful prayer life, we also ask for the grace to avoid obstacles that may hinder the development of a powerful prayer life. The following are the hindrances to an effective prayer life. Number 1. Unconfessed sins. Psalm 66, verse 18 says, Had I cherished evil in my heart, the Lord would not have heard. Knowingly tolerating sin in our lives is pushing God away from us, and therefore making our prayers powerless. However, when we confess our sins sincerely, God will forgive us, and our slate will be wiped clean. Our relationship with God is then restored, and our prayers regain their power. Number 2. The lack of faith. The letter of James, chapter 1, verse 6, says, But he should ask in faith, not doubting, for the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea that is driven and tossed about by the wind. Prayer has no power without faith. Our faith is weakened with doubt, and it separates us from God and gives us the tendency to move back and forth like the waves rather than being steadfast in our faith. Number 3. Disobedience. Keeping free from sin is not enough. We must back this up with our actions, which will show a strong display of obedience to the Word of God. Acts of obedience are important because these are the natural outcome of our faith. He who obeys God trusts God, and he who trusts God obeys God. Number 4. Unforgiveness. Matthew chapter 6, verses 14 to 15 says, If you forgive others their transgressions, your heavenly Father will forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, neither will your Father forgive your transgressions. Forgiving and being forgiven as inseparable twins. One cannot enter into prayer with bitterness and expect to come out with blessings. Number 5. Wrong motives. The letter of James, chapter 4, verse 3, says, You ask, but do not receive, because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. Our prayers will have much power if our motives are right. It is important to know what our motives for praying are. It is important to examine and discern what our real purpose for praying must be. Number 6. Idols or sinful attachments in our lives. Ezekiel chapter 14, verse 3 says, Son of man, these men had the memory of their idols fresh in their hearts, and they keep the occasion of their sin before them. Why should I allow myself to be consulted by them? What are the idols in your life? These are the things in life that one will not be willing to give up even if God is asking them to. These are the things that we refuse to release to God. Examples are material things such as money, pleasures, bad habits, and power. If we cannot give this up for God, then they are blocking our access to God. Number 7. Discord in the family. The family is the basic unit of society and of the church. It is where everything begins. We must bring our family to God and bring God to our family. Scripture says, a house divided against itself cannot stand. International Convocation of the Renewal in the Spirit in Rome on June 2, 2014. Pope Francis asked and said, where does division come from? And he said, division comes from the devil. Number 8. Disregard for God's sovereignty. In Matthew chapter 6, verses 9 to 10, the Lord tells us, this is how you are to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We must acknowledge that God is the one in charge. We have a relationship with Him. He is our Father, and we are His children. As His children, we have full dependence on Him. Jesus said, whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters. The words of Jesus are strong, and it has no middle ground. We must examine our commitment to Christ and choose to either gather with Him or to scatter. There is no middle ground. Number 9. Disregard for others. In John chapter 13, verse 34, the Lord says, I give you a new commandment, love one another. As I have loved you, so you also should love one another. God desires unity among all of us. Prayer helps us learn to love others because it is impossible to pray for a person while hating or criticizing that person. Prayer, in fact, breeds compassion and not competition. Number 10. Unsurrendered will. In John chapter 15, verse 7, the Lord says, if you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. In the parable of the vine and the branches, the branch depends on the vine for its needs, and this results to great fruitfulness. Therefore, as we surrender our will to God, we receive the power of Christ through the Holy Spirit, thereby allowing us to bear much fruit. As we ponder and meditate on the content of this module, let us ask ourselves the following questions. What is the main hindrance to my prayer life? How does this hindrance enter my prayer life? What am I going to do about it? How do I plan to improve my prayer life, thereby gaining power for my prayers? In the meantime, this is Brother Dick inviting you to join me in our closing prayer. Father, give us the grace to nurture a fruitful prayer life, and bless us with a powerful prayer life as we try to avoid hindrances that brings us away from you. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hi, you are viewing Disciples of the Word YouTube channel.
In Jesus' name.